Hello. So we are talking about habits today. I put a list up of things that you can implement for health and wellness, okay? These are small actions that create big change, but they're habits you have to implement and you have to have a plan around. And one of the things I see most of is people doing very unrealistic, not honest goals, and then they can't even create a habit around it. And so one example is that you want to run a 5K. So you need to really look, like, do you even freaking like to run? Do you like to run? Okay, because if you don't like to run, then why is your goal to run a 5K? Is it to lose weight? Is it an accomplishment? Like, you have to work backwards and think, is that even something that's attainable? Because sometimes we get caught up in unrealistic things that we don't even like to do. And so if you hate running, if you have a knee injury, let's say, and you are just not going to fulfill that, why are you setting that in the first place? Okay, second, if you do like running, okay, then you need to set the habit around that. You need to get the app on your phone. You need to set days that you're going to run and implement running as the habit every single day without excuses, without fail, and how that works. And so maybe it's 4 days a week you're going to start walking first, and then you're going to do a long walk, and then you're going to start running and walking and those sorts of things. But you can't just say, I'm going to run a 5K, because that's the big idea. That's the motivation. And that's the excitement around it, and that you think of something, but then what is the habit that achieves that? That's where the discipline, that's where the habit forming creates the behavior. Another thing is, like, I've seen this one acted out by one of my favorites, is that you want a six pack for summer, okay? In order to have a six pack, because we all have muscles, you need to eat very restrictive foods, calories. You need to be in a deficit for a long time and lose all of your body fat, because it's the last to go. That's just realistic. Six packs are not easy. You cannot be drinking alcohol, because that right away just stops the fat burn. You have to be very strategic about your workouts and very committed to them. And so it's like, great, you can say, I want this six pack, but do you really? I mean, do you really? Because that requires you to stop eating the chocolate and crap and french fries. That requires you to be in the gym and working really strategically. That requires you to stop drinking the wine or beer, even, you know, the small amount you drink. That requires a lot of effort to get there, okay? So if you're not gonna give up those things, don't set that intention. Okay? Set something realistic, like you want to lose some inches off your waistline. How can you achieve that? You can achieve that by starting movement. You can achieve that by drinking more water. You can achieve that by substitutions of foods. You can achieve that by small habits that you can outline to get to lose that inch, so that your waistline is thinner. You may not have a six pack, but you will look and feel better around your stomach area. But don't put it at so far that I'm gonna do this six pack, because that's unrealistic. And that's when we start getting into that hack, like, I gotta do it fast, I gotta do it this. It won't happen fast. It just doesn't. That's real, like, unrealistic expectations and goals that we set. So we can't even form habits to reach them. So really important this week, pick from the list, add to your own, pick one or two, post it up for me. And then how will you build that habit in, so there's no excuses around the habit, okay? If it is to drink more water throughout the week and you're gonna drink half your body, then you need to have a water bottle that has a measurement on it, and you know how much you're drinking, and you need to say, I'm going to drink one in the morning, at noon if it's 32 ounces, at noon, and then in the evening, and I'm gonna make sure that I drink those three bottles of 32 ounces to meet my goal. There's apps that have water checks. I'm gonna check it off, or I'm gonna just put it on a standard, you know, note card that I marked it off, or I'm gonna put it in the notes of my phone. But I'm gonna do it every single day for 7 days and see how that changes my mind and how I feel around my body. Because just drinking water can push toxins out, can change big things in your body, your skin, your complexion, your energy levels, because most of us are walking around dehydrated. So again, pick one of those and then figure out backwards what could sabotage it. What do you need to implement every single day as a habit? And then you continue those. I can't wait to hear.